Hello guys, welcome once again. In the last video, I have shown you that how can you create a PDF file via a button. Okay, so in this video, you can see that the code is here. So you can see file.pdf has been created by this button, and this is the file explorer where I have created this PDF file into my project file. Okay, so my project file contains my PDF file. So if you don't know that, then I will recommend you to go and watch my previous video in which I have shown you how to create a PDF file and how to write a paragraph in it. So now in this video, I'm going to be showing you that how can you create a list inside your PDF file. For example, you write so many things and you want to give each heading, or you can say a point. You want to make each one a point, so that would be called as list. So how to create that? For that we have a list. So don't forget to import iText sharp dll file. So in order to do work with this video, you need to watch my previous video. That is mandatory because I have used some libraries. Okay, so list, and then create an object like L is equal to new list. All right, and inside the parentheses you need to write list dot, and now you can see that there are several types of list here. So what I will do, I need a ordered list, let's say. So I will click here, list dot ordered. So now whatever my list will be made, it will be made like in the form of the ordered list. Okay, so now I need to write here L, my object, L dot add. Okay, and inside this parenthesis I need to write like this a string, you can say, and inside, and I will copy this for let's say how many times. So how many points you have, you'll copy it that many times. Okay, so this will be the string. Okay, let's say 4 times. So this will be the string that will appear in your PDF file. Okay, so first of all, you need to define that this is the first item of the list. So you have to do it for the first time, for the first element of the list. Okay, so for the other items, you don't need to specifically write that. So for the first item that you need to add, you need to write here new list item. List item, yes. And now inside the parentheses, you're gonna be writing this, the string, let's say. So this is the first element, so I will write here first element of list. Okay, like this. Okay, so in here now I will write here second element. Okay, so same like that, I will write here third element. Okay, now I will write here fourth element. So this is your list actually. So now you are pretty much done here, but you need to add only one line here, and that is doc dot add, like this. You need to specify that now your list has been added to your document. So for that, what you will do, you'll write here specifically doc dot add, and inside here you will pass that object of the list, and that is L. So copy that and paste it right here. Okay, so now you are pretty much done here. So first of all, we're gonna go here and we'll see that in our PDF file what we have. Before running our program, we will open our PDF file and we will see what is inside of that file. So you can see the file is opening, and you can see that there is only one paragraph here and there is no list yet. So now when we will run our program and when we will create our file by hitting that button again, so what will happen, let's see. Run our program. So it will take a while. So now our program has started running. So we'll add our credentials and I'll write my password also. So I'll hit login and it will tell me shortly that login successful. So it tells me login successful. I'll hit OK and that kind of window will open up. And here you can see that I have the button that I created in my previous video, create a PDF file. So I have already created. So what it will do when I will hit that, it will just replace that file. OK, so we just need to hit that create a PDF file and it has been created successfully. So we'll hit here and we can see that a list of ordered number has been created. In the same way, you can create an unordered list and you can create alphabetic lists, you can create a numerical list, whatever kind of list you want. And you can also change the position of the list on the page. And okay, let me show you how can you do that. I'll stop debugging, I'll stop my program. Okay, yes, and I'll go to the code. And in here, right here, you can say that you have to put a comma and you'll just write here 30f, let's say. So run your program again, then you have to create your file here, put credentials 123, login successful, hit OK, and this form will be opened. Now create a PDF file. It is showing me some kind of error because my file is opened, so I need to close that. That's why it has not created it. So I'll stop debugging again. I'll run my program again. I'll give my credentials. Okay, 123, login successful, create a PDF file. Yes, most probably the changes have taken place. So now I will hit you can see that it has created a difference between a space between these numbers. Okay, so if you want to create if you want to move these numbers along with, then you have to write indentation dot left and inside that you're gonna give the values. Okay, so I'm gonna also show you that. Let's see how can you move these number also. So focus on that. And now you will go stop debugging, close your program running and come here. Just you need to write a line here, L dot indentation left, and you're gonna put it equal to 30f, let's say, and put a comma here. So now you are done here, your indentation will take place. I hope you have noticed the previous point, the previous form of the file. So now put the credentials in, give the password, okay, and now create PDF file. So now file has been created successfully. Go here, hit the button, and you can see the numbers have also been moved from here to here. Okay, so I hope you have got the concept here. Thank you so much for watching. And in that way, you can create as many changes in the list as you want. You can also create sublists using the same method. And okay, so you have just need to use a little bit of the brain. So I hope you have enjoyed today's video. Thanks for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and bye for now.